Adobe, they've been working together very closely on this new product that's you know, that's about to launch. And we've had an excellent relationship. You know, the guys at Adobe and QNX and Rimmer are really fantastic. They've done a great job with this product. You know, we work very closely to implement things like Flash and Air on this device right into the operating system. You know, to give you that optimal performance for Flash that hasn't been seen on previous devices. Yeah, so one of the first things you notice is, of course, how portable this thing is. It's only 10 millimeters thick, only weighs 400 grams. So I don't need any special thing to carry it. You know, it feels very natural, very comfortable. I can put it into my backpack, you can carry it in your purse. And just to speak a little bit more about its ports here, we've got micro USB, which most BlackBerry devices already have. But one cool thing I really like is the micro HDMI, and that allows me to hook this up to a TV and project full 1080p video, which again is great to have, you know, when you're on the road and you want to do presentations and that kind of stuff. The other thing you'll notice is I'm actually running multiple applications here at the same time. I'm running up to around 8 or 9, and it's very snappy. There's no impact on user performance or you know, or the experience here. And this is thanks to the technology of QNX Systems that we acquired last year. They have what's called a microkernel real-time operating system that allows the playbook to actually do this, to run multiple applications and do symmetric multiprocessing, which is unique to the playbook. And that gives us the snappy response and high performance that you see here. Yeah, so we at Rimmer understand that, you know, web standards and open frameworks, they matter to people and to developers. So we're actually big supporters of HTML5 and web standards such as Flash. So we want to actually meet developers, you know, in their own environments with using the tools that they're comfortable with. So whether you're a web developer that's using Dreamweaver, or whether you're somebody who's using Adobe CS5 or, you know, or Flash or Flash Builder, we want to make sure that you are comfortable with those tools. We don't want to bring you out of those environments. So we're actually making SDKs and frameworks available that you can use using the familiar tools that you're already using today.